Yo, 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 what is up, guys? Hope you guys are doing well. It's your boy Faris coming at you with a brand new video. And in today's video, I'm going to be going over how I'm making almost $100 a day trading using the Lux Algo Trading Indicator. And now, if you guys don't know what that is, well, you're missing out big time. You can check out previous videos I made on them by clicking up here or down in the description box below. Essentially, what it does, it tells you when to buy and sell any given asset. So whether it's stocks, crypto, Forex, anything that's listed on TradingView, it'll tell you when to buy and sell, which is an amazing thing to look at and can be a huge blessing when you're trading. So what I'm going to do is share with you what I look at, what I do that has helped me generate almost $100 a day trading using this method. And obviously there's some days where I don't make as much and I'm in the negative, but this has helped me across the board. The best part is it's super simple to do. So if you guys already have your own strategy, which I assume most of you guys do, you guys don't have to get rid of it. You guys can just add this strategy, which I'm going to be showing you on top of it. And it's just an added confirmation. You guys can look at this, look at your own strategies, just an extra thing you guys can look at when making trades. So before we get into the video, do I even have to ask you guys what to do? Smash that like button, subscribe if you guys haven't already. We just hit 5,000 subscribers. The next milestone is 10,000, which I hope we can hit by the end of the year, but only you guys can help me with that. So with that being said, let's head on to my strategy. First things first, you're gonna want to have Lux Algo, and if you guys don't, you can just hit the link in the description box below and you guys can use the code FA10 and you can get 10% off your first month. Like I said, if you want to know more about it, I made plenty of videos on it and you can check it out in my previous videos. The first thing I do is utilize their Discord. Now, if you guys didn't know they have one, well, now you do, and it's completely free if you guys have the subscription. So why not take advantage of the resources you guys have? So let me grab my phone and show you the first thing I do. All right, so once you're in your Discord app, you're gonna want to go to the Lux Algo server. Once you're in there, you're gonna want to scroll down to the live bot scanner. And what this does, it tells you signals from all across the board, whether it's stocks, crypto, Forex. It'll tell you when to buy and sell, so you're not constantly monitoring just a couple pairs. It'll tell you a whole bunch of different asset classes that you can buy or sell. So for this example, I'm gonna use Forex because a lot of you guys wanted me to use that. So I'm just gonna hit the Forex tab over here, and over here we can see a whole bunch of different pairs along with the sell or buy signal and the time frame. This is actually awesome because you don't have to constantly monitor different pairs. It'll tell you exactly different pairs that you guys can take your positions in. The most crucial part when you're doing this is having your notifications turned on, so you know whenever a signal is released. And you can do this easy by just clicking the Forex part on the top, go to notification settings, and you can just turn this on to all. And anytime a signal is released, you will get a notification on your phone saying exactly how it is, the pair, what is it, a buy or a sell, and the time frame. So let's just say we got a signal. So for example purposes, like I said, I'm gonna use Forex. Now what do? Now I head on to my TradingView account and look at a couple more things. So let's head on to my computer. All right, so I'm on my computer now. I forgot to mention that if you guys don't want to download Discord on your phone, you can just have it on your computer and have everything on your computer. You could do it that way as well. So going through my examples, so I'm on the Forex tab where I was on my phone. So let me just go through one of them and use for example. So let me use something for a couple days back so we can see how it played out. All right, let's stick with the USD's Canada one. So all you're gonna want to do is go over here, type in the pair, so USDCAD. Once you have that pulled up, we can see the chart once it loads. All right, so I have the chart pulled up on my computer over here. So the first thing you're gonna want to do is open up Discord. I just wanted to double check. So it was a buy signal on the 4-hour chart, which I am on right now. It was yesterday at 12 a.m. So what I like to do is to see if the exact settings I use gave me a signal as well. So everyone has their own settings that they use for what type of trader they are. So for me, my settings a little more less sensitive, so it gives me a more confident trade. So as we can see, if we were to have taken this right away, I didn't get a signal. I didn't get my signal for, let's say, a couple hours, probably a whole day later, I didn't get my buy signal. The next thing I do is go up here in the indicators and type in moving average. We're gonna do this twice. You're gonna hit this twice. As we can see, we have two moving averages come up. The next thing I do is go into the settings and change this to a 13, and let me make this a little more thicker for you guys. Let's do red for this one, and for the 9 we're gonna change it to a 34.
Make this a little thicker as well. Oh,
Once you do that, this is just the 13 day in the 34 moving averages. How this works is anytime the orange crosses below the blue, usually we see a price movement to the downside and then vice versa. So as we can see over here, if we zoom in pretty close, we're actually really close to a cross over here. We haven't hit it yet. The indicator actually gave it to us back over here, but we're not hitting it over here. So this would probably be something I would put on my watch list and see how it plays off, because like I said, you don't know the settings that the bot gives, so you want to do it to where it's the settings that you use, because it's your, obviously you tweaked it to your own settings. So now would actually be a good time, because one, I have my indicator that tells me to buy, two, that moving averages is really close, so I would actually wait until a cross comes and then take my position. Another thing I also look at when taking trades is, let me go, so sorry, I only have three on my TradingView account, so it's called relative strength index. So what this does is it indicates whether so for this case a pair is overbought or oversold. So anytime it is above the 70, it's considered overbought, below the 30 is oversold. So what I like to do is hope the pair or the stock is trading in between this area. So as we can see, it's overbought. Preferably not like to buy when it's overbought, because we know the price is going to come down eventually. So if we look at both the indicators, so I had a buy signal, the moving averages were really close but didn't hit it yet, and then the RSI is indicating overbought. So would this be a trade I would take? Honestly, this is something I would probably put in my watch list and just see how it plays off for the next couple of hours or maybe days, and then possibly take my position. Also, one thing you guys should understand is that everyone's strategy is unique to them. Not everyone's goals are the same. So like I said, my goals are long-term trades, whereas yours might be scalping. So the strategy that I'm using might work for you, might not work. I'm just making this video so I can share with you what I do for the trades I make. So yeah, it's best if you tweak it your own way into the settings that you like, so it works perfectly for your trading. I also sometimes look at, it's called the VWAP and the MACD indicator. So I'm just gonna look, open this real quick. I'm not gonna go in depth into this because I only use this when I'm on super on the edge about a trade. I don't use it constantly, so I'm just gonna turn the histogram off for this one. But yeah, I sometimes use the MACD or the VWAP. They're great indicators as well. The MACD and the RSI kind of go hand in hand. The VWAP is a little bit different, but if you guys want me to make a more detailed video on those two indicators, just let me know. I'll make a video on that. But I usually just stick with the RSI and moving averages. Like I said, sometimes MACD and sometimes VWAP. Another thing I like to do is having a take profit and a stop loss set when I get into a trade, just in case things go south, you aren't in a bad position. So what I like to do for this, go over here, go into the settings of Lux, I'll go and click trade setup. And what this does, it gives you a stop loss and a take profit level. So you guys can use these or use your own. I personally just use my own take profits and stop losses. This is a great way that you guys can check, or if you want to put a stop loss set when you're taking a trade, just in case, you guys can use this as well. I just use my own take profit and stop losses. I put them in based on like how volatile the pair is and different indicators, and you know how fast I want to get out of a trade, or if I'm in it for a long term, I'll adjust them accordingly myself. I'm sure you guys can tell when I went through this real quick that I don't have hundreds of indicators that I look at. I stick through only a couple, and that's because I tested a lot throughout the couple months, and this is personally what worked best for me. And also, why would I have all of these indicators when I'm paying for this monthly subscription? It's best if I utilize the resources. So whether it tells me a buy or sell, it's best to use that. So what's the point of having all these other indicators if it's just gonna clutter my screen up and make me even more confused when I bought this to make myself less confused? All right, so let's do another example real quick, just so I can show you guys. So we just did the USD CAD one. So let's scroll up and find another one that we can do. Let's go further up. Let's do the EURUSD one. So we're just gonna go over here and type in EOR USD. If you go over here, all right, so this is the chart. I have the moving average set up. Let me just turn off the take profit so we don't get confused. So as we can see, let me pull this up real quick. We got the signal at 10:13. It was on the 4-hour chart. So this was probably around over here that the bot gave the signal. So I didn't get my signal for probably, I would say, another 3 or 4 hours later, when this bar closed, I got my signal. First things first, we saw that the price was obviously, for the 1334 moving average, it was definitely bullish. So we saw a little downward trend over here. Would I have taken it? Probably not, because it might have just been a little dip with another rise. But I probably would have waited a little bit longer till the moving averages crossed, which happened over here, and we saw this huge drop over here. So I probably would have taken the trade over here. So let me just X out of one of these or both of these and look at the RSI real quick. So if I go to the RSI relative strength index, we can see that during the call or the indicator, it was hovering in between the purple area, which was good. So it didn't indicate that it was overbought or oversold at the time. But as we can see now, it is considered oversold right now. So it's probably a good position to maybe take a long position on it right now. We'll see how this plays out. So would I have taken this position? I think I personally would. So the call came over here. I didn't get my signal for probably a couple hours later, but the moving averages, as we remember, was still in the bearish movement. So I personally would have not taken this trade. I think for the same thing, I would put it in my watch list and see how it played out. So once I got my signal and we saw the cross between the 1334 average over here, I probably would have taken the trade somewhere over here and also looked at the RSI and gave me another interpretation over there. This probably would have been a quicker trade for me. I probably wouldn't have gone long term on this trade, mainly because of how spread out the 1334 moving average was. And yes, obviously I have my own stocks and crypto watch list throughout the week that I create and I make trades based off. This is just something extra that, you know, if I ever get a notification through the bot, I can just take a quick look and see if it's a good trade to get into and make some extra profit doing it that way. Well, that is it for today's video, guys. Like I said, this is something that I do. If you guys want to copy it, go ahead, tweak it up. Just know that it might or it might not work for you. Like I said, we all have different goals and settings, and there's a lot of factors that go into it. So probably the best way is tweak it up to what works best for you and do it that way. Remember, if you guys don't have Lux Algo yet and you trade, you're doing yourself a huge disservice. As you can see, it tells you when to buy and sell. But if you want, you can use the code FA10 and you guys can get 10% off your first month. So if this video has brought to you any value, please drop a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in next week's video. Peace.